get quite a few questions about shadows. It seems to confuse people a bit. And I looked through all my videos on YouTube and suddenly realised I hadn't really done a video about it. So here we go. I'm going to try and explain it more for you. Now, the only light I've got on is one light directed onto this ball, so I hope that's going to be sufficient. Now, I just want to explain, this is a round manufactured ping pong ball, so it's going to be perfectly spherical. Now, there's the light source, or the sun, if you wish. Now, if we were to say this is a building, and this is the sun up here, okay? If we go higher up, the sun is rising, it's getting hotter and hotter, it's going around, and it's at the top. The light source is going down, so the shadow there is being cast directly downwards. Now, if I continue with the sun idea and it goes over the other way, then you can see the shadow the other side. Okay, we've got two eggs. So the light is coming from there, it's coming down and it's hitting that egg, and can you see the side of that egg is very bright, and then on this side there's a shadow. Now look very closely, my friends, this catches a lot of people out. The shadow follows the curvature of the egg. Whoops. Okay, it doesn't go straight, it follows the curvature. So always make sure, this catches a few of you out, and it makes such a difference to making things believable. The shadow follows the shape of the object. Likewise, the light is hitting that. It's, excuse me. The light is hitting that, it's very bright, and the shadow is on this side. And again, the shadow follows the shape of the object. Now, what's happening as well is that you have got something called reflected light. So, that light hitting that side of the egg, which is very bright, is actually bouncing back onto that egg. So, if you look carefully, and I hope you can see this on camera, seeing as I don't have professional people to help me, can you see that you've got this shadow here and then it's actually a bit lighter there? That might be a little too much detail for what you're doing though generally, but it's something for you to be aware of. It's very helpful to know about that. Now, you've also got then the shadow from this egg casting onto that egg. Again, a lot of you miss that out. The group of cherries, for example, you get lovely shadows on one cherry, but you forget that that cherry is going to cast a shadow onto the one it's next to. So you've got that egg is casting a shadow onto that egg, and you can see it's in there. Okay, now the shadows cast by the eggs, it's going to be the shape of the object, okay? So here it is, you can see it coming round here, and I don't know if you can see it coming the other side. Now, this one is at a slightly different angle, so the shadow is going to be longer. It's going to be that shape. And again, like with the ping pong ball, if I start to adjust where the light source is coming from, ooh, you can see how much the shadows are changing, where the light is bouncing. Now, I'm going to really confuse you now and say you can, of course, sometimes have two light sources. Oh, deep joy, Nicola. Now I'm really confused. This doesn't happen very often. Well, it does, but it's probably something in your everyday work that is getting to a more advanced stage. So let's just switch that off. So really, the main thing probably that most of you are at the moment is to be aware of the simple shadow cast the position of the light and the position of the shadows that adjusts with the direction of the light. Now, one other little thing. Let's take away the eggs. And here we have a nice carrot. Okay. So, what happens here? If you lift, this is good to remember for branches and things like that. If you lift that up, can you see how the shadow, it's not quite a good position, the shadow has shortened. The shadow, and I see this a lot as well, the shadow doesn't stick to the object, it's on the surface that the shadow is being cast onto. And it will change according to where it's going. Now, I'm holding it so it's suspended. See, the shadow is on the surface that the shadow is being cast upon. So, I hope that helps you. Three things, basically. The direction of your light, bouncing light, strong colour this side. Let's come to an apple, because that's where most of you are doing this exercise. Okay, so light bouncing onto there, bright colour. Look at that highlight, lovely, lovely highlight. Again, the shadow follows the shape of the apple on the actual apple itself. Okay, it's where the light is. That side of the apple is darker, it's in shadow, and there is your shadow cast by the apple. Let me see if I can get the stalk. Okay, the stalk. Let me see if I can get the lighting a bit. I don't think I can. You can probably see, look, there's the stalk and there's the shadow cast accordingly. So I hope that helps you, my friends. So you have bright light, shadow on the object, the shadow follows the shape of the object, the shadow is cast, and then you have shadow, bright light, shadow on the side of that, the shading, and the shadow that is cast onto that. So enjoy, practice, get a bright light and a few objects, and it will all become perfectly clear.